Two U.S. lawmakers are making sure President Donald Trump sends out a clear message to President Rodrigo Duterte that the United States will uphold fundamental human rights, including due process and the rule of law. Congressmen Randy Hotgren and James P. McGovern, co-chairs of the Tom Lantos Human Rights Commission, sent a letter to President Trump urging him to use his upcoming meeting with President Duterte as an opportunity to express the U.S. profound concern over alleged extrajudicial killings committed under the Philippine government's anti-drug campaign. The letter cited very strong evidence that the Philippine police have killed 7,000 alleged drug dealers and users without charges or trial. These lawmakers insisted that while the United States reaffirms its ties with the Philippines, it should also stand its ground when human rights are being violated. And joining us now via phone from Palo Alto, California, is Ago Pedalizo of the Filipino Americans for Human Rights Alliance. Thank you for joining us on BA, Ago.
Oh, hi, Gail.
Tell us about how your group has lobbied in the offices of various lawmakers to draw attention to the alleged human rights violations in the Philippines under the Duterte administration.
Hey, Gail, it's always a product of concerted efforts by different groups. Definitely main players would be the Ecumenical Advocacy Group Network, the FARA, and other groups like Amnesty International, Human Rights Watch, that are kind of affiliated with the same advocacy. And we do an all-round approach to this, looking at different committees or organizations that would affect the process of the bill. So you have to focus on the Senate Foreign Relations, the State Department, the Human Rights Caucus, but really focus on the Republican districts who are actually in power to make and introduce the bills.
Well, obviously, they are listening to you. Now, do you think the letter that Congressman Randy Hotgren and James B. McGovern sent to President Trump will actually make him raise U.S. concerns over reported extrajudicial killings under Duterte's war on drugs?
Well, Jack, it's actually the fear of political isolation that will motivate both President Trump and Duterte to make the move. I mean, obviously, overnight, I don't expect them to honor the Constitution, honor basic human rights. But the fact that mainstream Republicans and Democrats have aligned themselves and promised to the constituents that we're going to uphold the law despite any efforts to build bridges with economics and military alliances, I think that's a main message and a signal to them that, hey, you know what? You have to do your job the right way.
Good point. And also,
Jill, let me point out that Trump is being is on the verge of being isolated by not only Democrats, but by the Republicans as well. And Duterte is being isolated by the AFP and DND, who are more affiliated with the U.S. than China. So again, for fear of isolation, they're going to do it the way it should be.
Now, how else can U.S. lawmakers put pressure on the Philippines to protect human rights at all times?
You can do it in many ways. I mean, looking at the foreign aid, looking at the military aid and how they're being spent. But for now, though, the main push of most advocates is to introduce and have a committee hearing on the anti-EJK bill that was filed by both Senators Cardin and Rubio. Specifically, we're looking at the district of Republican leader Ed Royce in Southern California and the Senator Bob Corker from the state of Tennessee to introduce the bill, make an effort, educate the people, and make an effort to really uphold the law.
All right. Thank you for joining us via phone from Palo Alto, California. Ago Pedalizo of the Filipino Americans for Human Rights Alliance.
Thank you, Jill.